Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Sonny Onoo.
What in the world is going on here?
I don't know. I heard one fall, Sonny Onoo.
Well, one fall, pins are paused, and Sonny Onoo walks into the ring.
Now remember last week, Sonny Onoo promised us that Masahiro Chono's nightmare would be in Nashville tonight.
Ladies, he brought his wife?
Gentlemen, the nightmare of Chono, the Great Muta!
Oh, my goodness! Oh, my!
Well, you know the history of this one from Japan today. Go ahead, shoot your mouth off.
What a bombshell this is, Mike, today.
What an interesting situation is these longtime rivals in Japan. And since Masahiro Chono was officially announced as the first international member of the NWO several months ago, he has been on a campaign in Japan to recruit the Great Muta for the New World Order. It's a very similar situation to Sting here in the States, but Muta's allegiance has been in question.
The Great Muta, the nightmare of Masahiro Chono. Muta and Chono here on WCW Monday Nitro. What a big-time main event this is.
And our longtime WCW fans, I'm sure, remember the Great Muta as a former WCW World's Television Champion. Of course, he's been the IWGP World's Heavyweight Champion with New Japan Pro Wrestling as well.
Well, Muta definitely has all the credentials. I mean, I know Chono from years of experience. Chono, this guy's one of the meanest of all the Japanese.
Masahiro Chono.
Chono with the NWO shirt. Now remember, as a member of the NWO, that means he may have some friends around to help out if the going gets tough, so to speak. So, you know, Muta, who is a great wrestler and a great champion, is maybe stepping into new territory here.
That's certainly the MO of the NWO. And as far as the Great Muta goes, this campaign over in Japan by Chono to recruit him, he should be very familiar with all of the members of the New World Order and their gang mentality.
Sonny Onoo presents the Great Muta and a shocker here on WCW Monday Nitro in this live telecast. 2 hours back at our regular starting time.
Well, look at Chono seems to be proud of the New World Order's shirt there.
For life.
Mark Curtis, the referee, assigned to this one, and here we go.
That's Muta.
Well, of course it is.
Oh, I was waiting for him to take off that veil or shroud, whatever it is.
You know, Chono, who is usually very arrogant, very bold, Mike, showing a lot of concern as he made his way to the ring, and rightfully so.
As well he should, Tony. We're just trying to figure out in this next chapter, in this situation between Chono and Muta, if Chono has decided to not recruit at this point Muta for the New World Order, if this is a situation now where he knows that Muta is aligned with Sonny Onoo.
You know, Chono, now he's very sneaky, one of the cruelest of the Japanese I've ever ran across. Different style than Muta, too. He won't fly like Muta. He'll try to get Muta down and make him suffer on the mat.
Of course, we see the famous green mist from Muta, so reminiscent of his previous appearances here in World Championship Wrestling.
Chono giving Sonny Onoo a chase, who seeks refuge behind the Great Muta here. And I'm not so sure if he really wanted to chase Onoo or just maybe wanted to rethink some strategy here, guys. Slowing the pace down.
I don't know, Japanese, you know, they're a different race. They're big on honor, whether it's right or wrong. And you can see carrying out the sword of the samurai was Chono, and that's heavy into the honor of Japanese tradition, but so is Muta. It's gonna be interesting here.
Very tentative start to this match.
Hey, look at Chono. He's not rushing into Muta. He's going to try to slow Muta down.
Actually, he's doing nothing, as a matter of fact.
That's what's keeping Muta from moving around.
Back to the corner.
Sonny Onoo looks perplexed.
Get him now! Get him now! Get him now!
Yes, you get him. He came all this way. Let's go.
Get him now!
very strange game plan on the part of the Great Muta.
Hey, Chono is not somebody to run into, I'm telling you.
Once again, down low, slowing the pace down here, and Muta has held in the ring, has not chased Chono on the outside as well.
Right, this is the game of chess we love right here. Chono's trying to get Muta in a position where he can take advantage of him, maybe using Sonny Onoo to distract his own man.
Well, I tell you, Larry, I love this game of chess as much as you do, but I like the game of chess when at least the two men will lock up. Here we go.
There's always a time and a place for that.
And the time and place is right now. Side headlock applied. And the chant of Muta being led here by Sonny Onoo down at ringside.
I think he's the only one chanting it.
Doesn't really have that headlock cinched in very tight on Chono at this point.
What are you doing? I want you to go.
What's Sonny Onoo? He's yelling at Muta.
What are you doing?
Hey, something.
Trouble within the ranks, obviously.
I don't know what's going on, but
Muta should be all over Chono.
Oh! Oh! And Muta's all over Sonny Onoo. The Great Muta.
What are they doing?
And Chono attacking Sonny Onoo here. Apparently this nightmare.
We are NWO.
That's backfired.
He said
we're NWO.
I guess we finally have an answer as to the allegiance of the Great Muta. He's joined the New World Order.
This is incredible.
You can't trust the Japanese. They have seven hearts.
You're seeing history in the making.
Now, I know Sonny Onoo's an opportunist, but he seized the wrong opportunity, obviously. They pulled a big swerve on him.
Memorial Day 1996, we saw the very first appearance of what would be the NWO. A year later, the Great Muta joins the ranks of the Outsiders, of Six, of Eric Bischoff, of Hollywood Hulk Hogan. And the list goes on, if I can use that term. Back with more live on Nitro.